Hey guys, Guild here. Today, we're going to cover the basics of the Nolvus installer, as well as some of the various options and what they do. Hopefully, I'll be able to answer any questions you may have as we go along, so we'll try and get right into it. First things first, head on over to nolvus.net and click on the Auto Installer button in the top header of the website. This guide already covers some of the basics, so make sure you follow along in addition to watching the video. Starting out on the Skyrim setup page, make sure you own the Anniversary Edition of Skyrim on Steam or the Anniversary Update for the Special Edition. GOG and Game Pass versions will not work for this. If you already own AE version, you'll need to uninstall and do a clean install as you go along the guide. After installing Skyrim AE or reinstalling, make sure the DLC options are enabled in Steam and launch Skyrim to download all the owned Creation Club content. Most of the time, a pop-up occurs that will prompt you to download them all. Other times, you may need to enter the Creation Club menu and prompt the download yourself. At this time, go ahead and check your graphics drivers for your relevant GPU and make sure they're all up to date. Check GeForce Experience for NVIDIA and AMD Adrenaline for AMD cards. Moving on to the requirements page, make sure you pay attention to this section for a variety of reasons. It is extremely important that you do not install the Modlist on an external SSD or an HDD. This can cause multiple issues. Pay attention to the different hardware requirements here, as these options and versions installed can only be changed by reinstalling the entire Modlist. There are no gameplay differences between versions, only minor graphical ones such as foliage and trees. Later on in the video, I'll show some comparisons. Continue on to making a Nexus account if you don't have one already, as well as obtaining your API key for the installer in the next step. Make sure to never share this key with anyone. Keep in mind that Nexus Premium is required for the installer to download mods automatically, and now is a good time to subscribe to Nexus for a month if you are not a premium member already. In addition, you will also need to make a Nolvus account, so now is a good time to do that as well. At the end of the page is a list of optional requirements. Unfortunately, these are not optional. They are mandatory for the program to run properly and launch. Make sure you have the versions of these required or your game will not launch or run properly. Moving on to the installation page, click the link to download the Nolvus dashboard. Make sure you note the warnings below the download link. 1. Make sure the install path is short, something like C/Nolvus or whatever drive it's on. And 2, do not move the dashboard during install and download process. Make sure you follow these warnings. When the Nolvus dashboard is done being downloaded, drop it into your newly made Nolvus folder at the top of a drive. This should look like C/Nolvus or whatever your drive is properly named. Once you have it in the folder, you can then run the updater. Give the dashboard a few minutes to install the required files and download the rest. At this point, you can select your Skyrim install manually or press the Auto Detect button. Point it to the right area manually if you have the Skyrim install in a strange folder or one Steam doesn't normally use. In the next screen, you'll enter your Nexus API key you generated earlier. Keep in mind not to share this with anyone else. The screen after this is the Nolvus credentials. Don't confuse this with your Nexus ones. After filling this info out, you'll arrive at the start of the installation options. Make sure to select your proper aspect ratio and resolution here, as the installer gives you proper patches and fixes for your ratio. If you select the wrong ones, make sure you go back and fix them before installation, otherwise you will need to reinstall later to get all these patches. Continuing on, make sure that your Nolvus instance paths are correct to what you would like, and that archiving is enabled if desired. Archiving saves a copy of the mods downloaded and installed to make reinstallation much faster next time around. This does take an extra 100 gigabytes of space. On the next screen is the performance options. These include graphical settings as well as extra options like physics or downscaling. First things first, we have the variant. You can choose between Ultra and Redux,
Make sure to reference the earlier requirements at 1 minute and 30 seconds to 2 minutes in this video if need be. Keep in mind that there are no gameplay differences between these versions, just graphical ones. The next section is anti-aliasing. Choose the proper one for your card, DLAA for NVIDIA RTX cards and TAA for AMD ones. Next is the Skyrim INI profile. This handles basic load-in distance, shadows, and other basic elements. This is the only setting that can be changed after install, so this one is not a big deal. After that is LOD options, standing for level of detail and distant objects. There is no LOD option for Redux, only Ultra. Pick an option suitable for your GPU, noting the requirements section from before and making sure not to overstress your parts. After that is some optional selections. Advanced Physics handles things like hair movement, capes flowing, and other various physics-based objects. Global Illumination and FPS Stabilizer are better left turned off, are not visually important, and can even lower your FPS on average. Continuing on, make sure you note the warnings about options not being able to be changed after installation. On the next screen, we have a variety of optional selections that can change gameplay. Keep in mind, like previous options, these cannot be changed without fully reinstalling. Make sure you choose what you would like. Starting off, we have a nudity option if you desire. It does exactly as it says. Second is female skin type, smooth for smooth skin, muscular for muscular. Third is hardcore mode. This changes enemy scaling, adds new poise mechanics, and generally makes the game much harder. Fourth is alternate leveling. This changes the base Skyrim leveling to an experience pool system that requires you to sleep and allocate points yourself. This is not recommended for a first-time playthrough. Fifth is alternate start. This changes the base Skyrim intro to a more configurable, personalized start. With a variety of options for your choosing, it lets you configure all sorts of things about your character. Feel free to check out my other video that briefly covers this. Last but not least is Fantasy Mode. This adds a few extra attack animations and a magical jumping mod. It arguably has the least changes out of any of these options. Make sure you note these options cannot be changed after installation. The next screen handles ENB options. This is a visual layer that can be changed later on, though not automatically. Feel free to check out my other video for the ENB comparison to help you make this choice. Keep in mind, if you want to use Cabbage ENB, you'll have to manually install it after the rest of the list is finished. Next up is page file configuration. This is extremely important if you have a low amount of RAM, like 16 gigs, and can even help on 32 gigs and up. Make sure you click the link in the installer and follow the instructions. It requires a full PC restart, but can be done at the end once installation is fully complete. Finally, we arrive at the summary page. This has a breakdown of all the options you've selected so far. Make sure you double check each option is what you wanted and select it. At the bottom, there is an error management section in case something occurs during the installer. Weigh the options for yourself personally and decide. Once you hit the start button, the installer will start the process of patching and downgrading your Skyrim install. Congratulations on making it through! At this point, you can kick back and just keep an eye on the process. If you run into any issues, feel free to join the Novice Discord and ask any questions you may have in the help channel. As always, thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in the Novice Discord soon.